Well, Cruze has been one of the most popular and impressive cars from Chevrolet's stable. But over a period of time, the company started seeing competition and the numbers of Cruze started to fall. And now, the company is bringing in the facelift version of the Cruze, which has interior and exterior cosmetic changes. The all-new Cruze will come only in 2017. But for the time being, let's find out how this one drives.
Unlike previous facelifts, this new face looks a lot better with a new bumper and front grille. This two-part grille remains more rounded, but new horizontal chrome slats added neat detailing. The fog lamp inserts and LED DRLs finished in chrome blend better than the previous facelift. The fog lamps are new too. The distinctive kinked headlights remain unchanged. The rear end doesn't get any cosmetic updates, but it's still smart looking. There's an integrated spoiler lip on the boot. In all, the makeover may not be all that complete, but this new Cruze still looks fresh.
The big change on the inside is the introduction of MyLink infotainment system, something that we've seen in Trailblazer as well. This is a 7-inch touchscreen which houses Stitcher smart radio functions, also iPad and iPhone voice recognition control and controls for the AC. So this is the new addition to the facelift.
Apart from this, there isn't anything very new which catches the eye in the cabin. The design of the dash is basic, the plastics are average, and cabin colors are same as before. What you like is the front and rear seats. It gives good support and holds you well. But headroom in the back is a bit of a problem due to sloping roof line. Under-thigh support is less, but they are comfortable enough.
Well, there's no change in the way it drives. It drives as great as it used to be, even though the engine is the old one, 2-liter turbo diesel engine, which churns out 166 PS and 360 Newton meter of torque.
New Cruze comes with manual and automatic versions, and we drove the automatic version. The power delivery is linear, the gear shifts are smooth. In general, performance is strong and enough. But what we like is the engine refinement levels, and they have improved so much more.
Well, even at very high speeds, you are in complete control of the car, and that really speaks volumes about this engine.
Chevrolet claims a fuel efficiency of 14.8 kilometers per liter with the new Cruze automatic. The ride and handling of the Cruze is nice and as usual because dynamics of the cars are unchanged.
The car rides and handles very well. Even at high speeds, you don't feel the car is out of control, and that speaks volumes of the engineering done on the car. Well, the overall driving ergonomics are really good. You feel in complete control of the car even at high speeds, and the engine and the performance of this car is something that I'm quite impressed about even from the beginning.
This Cruze is to stay till 2017. Next year, the all-new model will replace this.
Well, now time to tell you whether it's worth buying. Well, if you see, there have been no mechanical changes made to the car, which means that it retains its impressive power. Add to that some good features and new styling, which makes it an overall good package to consider. Well, the all-new Cruze will come only in 2017, so for the time being, this could be worth considering.